全球晶片荒导致汽车业、手机业以及电子类产品都在抢晶片。欧洲联盟日前公布欧洲晶片法案计划，斥资超过430亿欧元，约合新台币1兆3700亿元的公共和民间投资，目标在2030年欧盟市占率能翻倍至20%。
The first goal is in the short term to increase our resilience to future crises.Increase our resilience by anticipating and thus avoiding supply chain disruptions. And the second part is, of course, looking at the midterm and there to make Europe an industrial leader in this very strategic market.
继美国提出美国创新暨竞争法案，欧洲也加快提出相关法案来应对过度依赖亚洲制造的晶片问题，并公开表示台湾在半导体制造领域有非常重要地位，开放台湾企业合作。
I know that some of the discussions taking place, they also include TSMC of Taiwan. Europe is open for business also for TSMC.
Taiwan is an extremely important region of the world where we know that today probably Roberto, only 50% of what we use is produced over there. So of course there's a lot of expertise and we are welcoming everyone, of course, in Europe. We are open, of course, including for these companies.
欧洲晶片法案主要计划增强欧洲在半导体供应链的安全竞争力与韧性，欧盟也在官方文件中明确纳入与台湾加强相关合作，对此我国外交部也回应表达高度欢迎，特别在后疫情时代，台湾与欧盟在半导体等全球供应链重组具有广大的合作空间。中央社记唐佩君布鲁塞尔报道。